All rise, please. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. For 1,000 years in thy sight are as but yesterday, when it is past. And as a watch in the night, so teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. O satisfy us early with thy mercy, that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Let thy work appear unto thy servants, and thy glory unto their children. And let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us, and establish thou the work of our hands upon us. Yea, the work of our hands establish thou it. Like as a father pitieth his children, so the Lord pitieth them that fear him. For he knoweth our frame, he remembereth that we are as dust. Gracious is the Lord, and righteous. Yea, our God is merciful. I was brought low, and he helped me. This is my comfort in my affliction. Comfort ye my people, saith your God. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared to the glory which shall be revealed in us. Unto thee, O Lord, do I lift up my soul. Turn unto me and have mercy upon me. For I am desolate and afflicted. The troubles of my heart are as enlarged. O bring thou me out of my distress. Look upon my affliction and my pain. Forgive my sins. O my God, my soul is cast down within me. All thy waves and thy billows are gone over me. Lord, hear my voice. Let thine ears be attentive to the voice of my supplications. I wait for the Lord. My soul doth wait. And his word do I hope. My soul waiteth for the Lord more than they that watch for the morning. I say more than they that watch for the morning. It is nothing to you, all ye that pass by. Behold and see if there be any sorrow like unto my sorrow, which is done unto me, wherewith the Lord has afflicted. The Lord will not cast off forever, but though he cause grief, yet will he have compassion according to the multitude of his mercies. For he doth not afflict willingly, nor grieve the children of men. Blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. Amen. You may all be seated. We are gathered here today for the homegoing or the celebration of life for our dear brother, Brother Jimmy Leroy Broussard, So I want to encourage you that we're here to celebrate. We're here to celebrate because when those that go home to be with the Lord, we celebrate. They've gone home. They're with the Lord right now. He is with the Lord, rather. So I want to say again, let's celebrate. Let's make this a celebration service. Amen? Amen, amen, amen. Let's all give the Lord a hand of praise. Amen, amen, amen. We want to do one more thing before we move into the service to start this celebration off right. I want everyone to just stand to your feet. If you know Brother Broussard and he's done something in your life, you ought to be rejoicing right now. You ought to be clapping your hands. Yes, 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 yes. Again, you may take your seats at this time. We're going to start this service off. Before we begin, my name is Gerald Wattis, the pastor here at Central Baptist Church. I want to greet each and every one of you. And again, to the family, I want to extend our heartfelt prayers and condolences to each and every one of you. This is a time that we go through grief, grieve how God has allowed you, but know that Jesus is with you during your time of grief. Amen? Amen. So we're going to start the program off with a scriptures brought to us, old and new, by Minister Ricky Grover. Then we're going to have a prayer of comfort by Minister Larry Haley, Dr. Larry Haley. Then we're going to have a song by Waymaker. Then we're going to have resolutions and acknowledgments brought to us by Sister Andrews. Then we have some more acknowledgments brought to us by Minister Grover. Then we'll move into the reflections at that time. Amen. So once we complete this part of the service, we're going to go into that. So let's give the Lord one more hand of praise at this time.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I stand before you today to give the Old and New Testament scripture, starting with the Old first, taken from Psalm 73, verses 24 through 26. Thou shalt guide me with thy counsel, and afterward receive me to glory. Whom have I in heaven but thee? And there is none upon earth that I desire besides thee. My flesh and my heart faileth, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. Psalm 73, verses 24 through 26, the Old Testament. The New Testament will be taken from St. John, the 14th chapter, 1 through 3. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believed in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. And there I am, and where I am, there ye may be also. May God have a blessing to the reading of and the hearing of his holy word. Amen? Amen. Bless you.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let us bow in a word of prayer. Truly, our gracious Heavenly Father, we do come once again to the throne of grace where we may find mercy and grace at this time of need. First of all, we thank you that you are God all by yourself and there is no other. We thank you that you've allowed friends and family to come from near and far. We thank you for the traveling mercy and grace that you have given already. We thank you, Lord, for the time that we knew Jimmy. And we thank you for the time we spent with him. We ask your choicest blessing, Father, upon this family right now. Father, that you would soothe their aching heart, calm their minds and their fears. We ask that you would grant them that peace that surpasses all understanding, that guards our hearts and our minds through Christ Jesus. We ask that you would lift them up. As they grieve, we pray, Lord, that they would grieve as those who have hope and not as those who do not have hope. And we know that you're the one that can grant it for them, Lord. Give them the peace they need. Give them the uplift they need. Give them the joy they need. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen, amen, and amen.
Miracle worker. promise, keep light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. A way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Yeah.
Can you hear me? First, honoring our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and to our pastor and to the ministers and to each of you, let us continue to rejoice, for this is the day that the Lord has made. And I say to the family, we offer our deepest condolences. And one of my profound memories of Jimmy. Each year I knew that I was gonna receive a Christmas card. He was so thoughtful. So I say to the family, keep all the good memories in your heart and let God be your comforter. Resolutions. Emma H. Wallace High School. Class of 1962. Resolution for Jimmy Brassad. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Matthew 5:4. Inasmuch as Jimmy Brassad was the beloved classmate of Emmett H. Wallace High School, class of 1962, and a dear friend to all of us, we put forth this resolution. Whereas our Heavenly Father, in his infinite wisdom and tender mercy, has removed from the trials and the cares of this world our friend and classmate, Jimmy Brassad, we pen this resolution to express our care and concern in this hour of bereavement caused by his demise. Be it resolved that we, the class of 1962, bow in humble submission to the will of God and command his spirit to him who sees all and knows all things. Be it resolved that it is our humble hope that it is the greatest of humility and respect that we bow to the divine will of our Heavenly Father, realizing that all things work together for good to them that love God. To the family and all who grieve, we extend our deepest sympathy, prayers, support, and love. Therefore, even as we mourn his going away from us, we resign ourselves to the Father's will. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to his family with our sympathy and prayer that the God we serve will bestow on you a large measure of consoling grace. Prayerfully and humbly submitted, Franklin George Alexander, Class President, Roberta Riggs McCall, Class Secretary. Mount Olive Missionary Baptist Church, Orange, Texas. Ronnie A.E. Crockett, Senior Pastor. Resolution of respect and loving memory of Mr. Jimmy Brassad. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, be also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. John 14, verses 1, 2, 3. Whereas in his infinite wisdom, God has sent the angel of death into our midst and into the new and everlasting life, Mr. Jimmy Prasad. Resolve that we, the members of Mount Olive Missionary Baptist Church, bow in humble submission to the will of God and commend the family of Mr. Jimmy Prasad to him, Jesus Christ, who makes no mistakes. Be it resolved, Mr. Jimmy Prasad was reared in a small city, Orange, Texas, and grew up in a village that we call The Lane. He was there always, had a smile for you, and was happy to see you. The Prasads were a big family, but God was always first in the household. The parents believe in bringing the children to church where they receive Jesus Christ as their personal advisor. Be it resolved that we bow in humble submission to him who never makes a mistake. And we pray that you fully rely on the Lord who heals all sorrow. When you hurt, we hurt. When you rejoice, we rejoice. And today, we rejoice with you, the beautiful life of Mr. Jimmy Prasad. Be it further resolved that we extend our sincerest prayers to his siblings, Sister Betty Curtis, Brother Freddie Ola Prasad, and Henry Deborah Prasad, all members of the Good Standing at Mount Olive Missionary Baptist Church, and to other family members of Mr. Jimmy Prasad. Earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. He will be missed by many, but let us continue to emulate his Christian character. 1 Peter 5:7 states, "Cast all your burdens upon him, for he cares for you." Resolved on this 21st day of October 2023, a copy of this resolution be given to the family of Mr. Jimmy Prasad and a copy kept in the church archives. Prayerfully submitted, Mount Olive Missionary Baptist Church, Reverend Ronnie A. E. Crockett, Pastor, Sister Geraldine Richard, Church Clerk. The church that cares for you, where everybody is somebody. Central Baptist Church, Carson, California. In loving memories of your beloved one, Brother Jimmy Prasad. But I would not have you be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not, even as others who have no hope. 1 Thessalonians 4:13. God wipes away all our tears and deliver us from all earthly ill. His love prompts it, his purpose determines it, and his power secures it. What a blessing it must be to be free and to be home with the one who redeemed us. We pray that you find peace and strength in the Lord our God, and that all your heartaches and feeling of emptiness will be met with faith, hope, and prayer. Whereas we serve a God who does all things well, and his tender and loving care, he has called the soul of your loved one to be with him. Brother Jimmy joined Central Baptist in March 1977 And although we have not fellowshipped together in many years, we still recognize his loving and thoughtful ways. Therefore, let it be known that we, the pastor, officers, and members, bow in humble submission to the Heavenly Father's will and extend to the bereaved family our heartfelt love and sympathy. As time passes and the memories bring more pain and tears, know that God is love. We pray that each passing day will help to heal the loss. Respectfully submitted, October 21st, 2023, Reverend Gerald Wattis, pastor. And all of these resolutions will be given to the family. Thank you.
To continue on with the acknowledgement, I'm going to read the acknowledgement that's in your program on behalf of the family. If you want to turn there, you can. Acknowledgement on behalf of the Broussard family. We deeply appreciate your kind expression of sympathy in our time of bereavement. We know our pain will decrease, and what will remain will always be. Love all whom you hold dear. Precious is the time you share. Do not wait for tomorrow may not be. Thank you for keeping us in your thoughts and prayers, the Broussard family. Amen.
Amen. Say praise the Lord. We're still in celebration mode, aren't we? Amen. Amen. I've just noticed in our midst, Councilman Hicks, if you would like to come up and give words to the family, I'm sure they would be honored. We have any other city officials in the house today? Any other city officials? Amen. So we'll move on after Councilman Cedric Hicks comes before us. So as he comes, let's give the Lord another hand praise. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, saints. Giving honor to God who is ahead of my life. It is very hard when you're in this profession to come and have to speak at this time. To the pastors here and to the ministry, thank you for your prayers and services. To the Broussard, which I always say is my other family, they are closer than most people would ever realize when I moved on Helmick Street about 22 years ago. Jimmy was the first person that welcomed me on the block. But his welcome wasn't a welcome that you would think would be a nice welcome. He said, oh, you just came in here like gangbusters. You done sat up here and cut down the trees and put new windows in and you done painted the building, you know, but I like it. Jimmy helped me a lot in doing a lot of work at my home. But when I got the information about his passing, it's ironic that the day that he would pass is actually on the birthday of my father, which is September the 25th. And to look at Jimmy as a father figure for me, because he was always there when I needed help and just, you know, conversating and talking with him about different stuff going on, he was always supportive in that process. To his boys, you guys, keep him in your heart. I know it's going to be a hard thing because, you know, he was at everybody's business and tell you what to do and what not to do. He was good at that. But understanding that, he said, you know, he lived a good life. You know, Jimmy did what he wanted to do when he wanted to do it, regardless of what somebody else may say or do, but he's going to do it his way. And for the Helmick, I think this is a lot of people on here. Can people who live on Helmick Street please stand up who's here? When you see the residents on Helmick Street, we are a real close-knit group in that to all of you guys, lean on us, whatever you may need, whatever hour it may be, understanding that no matter what we may say or do, you got to go through that grieving process, but I say keep God close. To those who are here, even though we go through this process, there's time afterward that they need to hear from us, not just now, but after the fact, because at any time and moment, things come upon, it's a memory that happens. But understanding that to be there with them during this time. And I look at his grandkids, you know, he loved both of them grandkids. My God, he loved them to death. But on behalf of the city council, on October the 3rd, we adjourned in his memory, in remembrance of Jimmy Broussard, for whose life was a legacy in our city and that we will forever keep him in our heart. It was signed by Mayor Lula Davis Holmes, Mayor Pro Tem Juwan Hilton, Councilman Jim Deere, Councilwoman Arlene Bogatia Rojas, and yours truly, myself, Councilman Cedric Hicks. So on behalf of the 98,000 residents, we feel your mourn, we feel it. He's part of the family, and if there's anything that we can do, I'm just right across the street.
Amen. Thank you, Councilman Cedric Hicks. Beautiful job, especially for the city of Carson. We're going to move now into our reflections. As you notice, it says 2 minutes, and it even says please. 2 minutes, please. So let's be considerate to the family and keep it at 2 minutes, amen? So we're gonna start with family. Family, I believe, is probably excluded. So we're gonna have any family members at this time, if you would like to come down and have words to encourage the rest of the family. Any family members, just come, amen, amen. Let's give them a hand as they come down. It's not easy when you're grieving. It's not easy to speak. Sometimes a thought will come to us and it gets tough. So let's keep them prayed up.
Good morning.
Morning.
First, giving honor to God, who's the head of my life. I am Uncle Jimmy's. I'm his niece. Henry Broussard is my dad. So when I was growing up, Uncle Jimmy would always come to Orange to visit us at home. And of course, he made me somewhat of a coffee chef. I was probably like only like 7 or 8 years old, and every time he would come, he would always ask me to make him a cup of coffee. And not a cup, a pot. So that's one of the memories that I will always remember from him, because it was like, my niece sure can make me a good old pot of coffee. And I would always take pride in making it, because I didn't even drink coffee, so I had no clue what I was doing. But if Uncle Jimmy said it was a good cup of coffee and it was a good pot, I was ready to make it like I was the best coffee chef or connoisseur, whatever you want to call it, ever. And he would always tell me how proud he was of me. And
it's okay.
He was definitely one of my favorite uncles, and I'm definitely gonna miss him. And I'm glad that I was able to see him a few years ago. And we got to take a picture, so I always hold it close to my heart. And I always remember him saying, call the police. After every comment, every sentence that he made. So Dwayne, Mark, Ryan, I'm praying for y'all. And it's I love y'all. And we're going to hold this family together. So that's it.
Amen.
My name is Niecy Broussard, and also from Orange, Texas. And Jimmy was my brother-in-law. And those of you that know Jimmy, probably the things we say, and you know all of them as well, because he would treat everybody the same. He loved to eat, and he would love my cooking. And when he would come, he would always tell me what to cook. And his favorite was gumbo. And he liked everything in it and on it and the biggest bowl you can find. He called me one time, and he was talking to my husband on the phone. He said, hey, tell Nisa to send me some of that gumbo out here. He said, I need some of that gumbo. I think I'd feel better if I had some of that gumbo. Y'all just freeze it and mail it. It's a way to do it. Just find out how y'all can do it and send me that gumbo. And that was something I will always remember. And I can see him now trying to fix him some gumbo right now, getting everything prepared for himself. And also, one of the other favorites, and all the family can attest to this as well, and friends and everybody. Jimmy loved to talk, and he'll talk for hours and hours on the phone, and if several people at the house, he want to speak to everybody. So when the phone came back to me one time, I told him, I said, well, Jimmy, I guess I'll let you go, and I'll check with you later. He said, what you mean, let me go? He said, I called you. I'm supposed to be the one to hang up first. So he wouldn't stop. He's just going to keep on talking, and you just have to hand the phone around to everybody else till he get tired of it. Then he say, look, so-and-so called me. I got to go. I'll call y'all later. And we, thank God. You know, we would be glad of that. But we are going to miss all of that with Jimmy. But we know that he is having himself a good time. He and Minnie Pearl are going to turn it out now. Thank you. And I love you, family. Ryan, Mark, you all did a wonderful job. And Dwayne, you all just keep up that legacy of what your parents taught you. You have a basic ground for everything in life that comes your way. And just make your parents proud and continue putting God first in your lives. Thank you.
This is for Dwayne, Ryan, and Mark. I just want you to know that Jimmy is absent from the body, but he's present with the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Jimmy has made heaven his home.
Yes.
And grief is a process. Mm-hmm. Take it one day at a time, one day at a time. But you have to trust in Jesus.
Yes.
Could I just ask all the veterans to stand, please? Any veterans?
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, veterans. I would just like to say thank you to you all and my brother for serving our country, for keeping us safe. Thank you.
Later. I bring you greetings from Shiloh Missionary Baptist Church in Plano, Texas, where our pastor is the Reverend Isaiah Joshua Jr. I am Jimmy's brother-in-law. I was married to his sister, Deb. But I didn't get to see him very often, but everything was brother-in-law. And he came over, I'll never forget one time. And when he came to the house, and in the living room area, we've got a fireplace in the middle. And on either side of the fireplace, there's this cabinet with pictures in it and a glass. And you can see all the pictures in it. Jimmy goes and walks over, and he looks at all the pictures. He sees all his brothers and sisters and different people. And then he walks over to the other side, and he looks at all the other pictures. And he looks at his sister, he looks at Deb, and he says, my picture's not in here. His sister looks at him and said, well, Jimmy, you're not dead. Everyone in that particular one had passed away, and it was all his brothers and sisters. So, Jimmy, if someone gives me a picture, even though your sister's up there in heaven with you, I promise you I will put your picture in with the rest of your sisters and brothers. And to Dwayne and Mark and all of you, hey, I have so much admiration. I am so proud of you. Y'all impress me. I thank God for all of you and for your wives and your children. Thanks.
Pastor, yes, ministers, Christian friends, good morning to you.
Good morning.
If you didn't say good morning to you, the people around, just turn around and say good morning, good morning, and good morning. I'm Nolan Anderson, and I am the husband of Jimmy's sister, Claudette, and my brother-in-law, Freddie, is going to follow me. But I first met Jimmy when I was stationed in Korea in 1972, and I had to come back TDY to the States. And on the way to my assignment in Oklahoma, I stopped in, and it was about mid-72. That's when Jimmy and I first met, and we didn't really call each other Jimmy or Nolan. We were always brother-in-law, and that meant something to me because he was a little bit older than me, and we had a chance to see each other at Dwayne and Jennifer's wedding a couple of years ago, and Jimmy was Jimmy. He will always be Jimmy, and I can see him now. You know what he's doing. But to Dwayne, Ryan, and Mark, and family, just like to share this few words of comfort, if I may. Death brings on heartaches no one can heal. But love, L-O-V-E, love, leaves cherished memories nobody can steal. Okay? Did you get that? So that means that whatever you are sharing between yourselves today, and you look at all of us who are here to celebrate Jimmy's life, that is just a few little groups of word. Hopefully, when those short, those soft days come, just look up and say, to God be the glory for all the good things he has done, he's presently doing, and it will always do. And when you need me, call me. Don't hesitate. Love to you. And on behalf and to my wife, I love you, and to the Broussard family, the Anderson family adores you just as well as we are part of your family once for all and always will be. Thank you.
First, give an honor to God, to the pastor of this great church. I am so happy to be here. Say a few words about my brother. I have so many memories of my brother, but I just want to let you know there's a few of those memories. I remember when we was growing up with my mother and father. Now, Jimmy always, whatever was on his mind, he would say it. I remember my mother told us to wash dishes. And Jimmy said, man, we're not going to wash no dishes because all these girls, they can wash them. To put it back, we was a family of 12, 13, one was born dead. So he said, Freddie, we're not going to wash dishes. Let the girls wash dishes. So my mother said, you wait till your daddy get here. So we didn't wash the dishes. My daddy came home and beat us half to death. We washed dishes. The next day, Jimmy wanted to do the same thing. Fred, we're not going to wash no dishes. I said, hey, Jimmy, this don't make no sense. I said, look here. Look here, daddy going to beat us half to death and we still going to wash dishes. We still not going to wash dishes. I said, Jimmy, this don't make any sense. Say, you're going to beat us half to death and we're going to wash dishes? I said, I'm going to wash dishes. So, oh, you're just afraid. I said, no, it just don't make sense. I'm going to wash these dishes. Another thing that happened, there's so many, but I want to mention this. Jimmy called me. I was on my way home from work. And he said, Freddie, how you doing? I said, how many did you do today? I told him, I said, man, I got one sitting on the side of me. He was talking a lot, and all of a sudden he got quiet. I said,
He's not saying nothing to me, but he's just looking at me. Jimmy said, man, I don't like this. So I'm not scared of him, but I don't like this. But I saw he was getting real serious. I said, Jimmy, I tell you what, we're going to flip the page. Say, like you tell me, flip that page, you know. But on the serious side, when my brother was in the hospital, you know, we prayed and I talked to him and he said, you know, he's going to try to beat this. And I told him, I said, Jimmy, you have to pray for yourself. I said, all you got to do is get in the corner and talk just like me and you talk. And talk to the good Lord. So the next day I called him and said, Jimmy, did you do what I asked you to do? He said, yeah, Freddie, I've done that. I said, well, I'm good. See, the thing is, what we have to understand, only Jimmy and the good Lord knew what he was going through. See, God saw fit to take him home. And we must understand that that's a journey that we all will have to travel one day. And one of the most important things, like I always tell all my friends, God do not hold you responsible how someone treats you. He hold you responsible how you treat your fellow man. And we need to keep that in our hearts at all times. Because one day too, when you meet God, he will never ask you what someone done to you. He's going to ask you, what did you do to them? And one of the most important things that my brother-in-law said about love, see, love is so important. See, God said, love everybody. Love your enemy that despitely misuse you. And we have to learn how to do that. And another, forgiveness. See, it's so powerful. When you think about where you come from, how God have forgave you for all the crazy stuff all of us have done, it becomes very easy to forgive one another. But you must remember, if you want God to forgive you, you have to forgive your fellow man. And you have to love everybody in spite of. And we have to often think about, I told my nephews this about God. I saw a sign that says, if you have God, that's all you need. See? We must always remember the love that my brother had for his kids, bought three boys and his grandkids. My brother really loved everybody because that's just how he was. He'll say what he have on his mind. I think we all have that little problem. But he really loved everybody. And yes, this is a film, but it's a home going. I mean, my brother's gone home. I remember when Jesus Christ was on the cross, had two thieves on the side of him. And one said, hey, if you're who you say you are, save yourself and save me. The other thief said, you know, this man have done nothing. We deserve what we're getting. And Jesus Christ stopped dying. And he said, this day, you will be with me in paradise. And we have to always remember. See, we got to understand, there's a lot of Christians in church, and that do not mean that you're going to get to heaven. And it does not mean that you're not going to get to heaven. Hopefully you're there. But a lot of times we as Christians look at somebody else and judge them. Now it would be so hard if God was like us. But see, God gives us love. He loves us all in spite of. So I just want to let you know that's one other thing that you have to always remember. If you can have prayer, when you need something, you pray, then you have faith, then you have patience, then you have praise God for all that he have done and are doing, and hope that tomorrow will bring a better day. Thank you.
To let everyone know how much she loved her brother. That's the only other sister besides Claudette that God has blessed to be here. And then Henry and Freddie. So the other sister, that's the only reason that she's not able to be here, Miss Betty Curtis. So we would like to extend love for her as well. She would want to say to her family, she loved her family.
Thank you, Pastor.
Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand praise. Amen. Amen. We're going to move on. Is there any more family members that would like to say anything before we move on? Once, twice, going three times. We moving a friend. Oh, okay. Hold on a second. We're recording. We're recording.
Okay. Look, first of all, I want to say this is a hallelujah time, a joyous time. We are celebrating the life of Jimmy Broussard, Jimmy Leroy Broussard. Hey, no more tears. Hey, don't cry. Rejoice. He made it over. He made it over. Jimmy was... He was something else. We come and visit him. You're right. He loved to eat gumbo. He went out and bought the biggest pots he could find. I mean, a pot that tall almost didn't fit on the stove. But, you know, I just want to say that what my brother said about being love, the greatest commandment. God wants us to love everyone. Hey, I know we have enemies, but he said, love your enemies. And that's what we're supposed to do. And I don't care if they black or green or what color. We're supposed to love each other. It doesn't matter about color. It doesn't matter about color. And help one another if you can. If you can spare a dollar or two, I'm sorry, I don't care what the policemen say. We cannot give to those people on the street asking for food. Hey, that's between me and God. I'm going to do it anyway. Even if I have to wrap up the change and throw it out there to them. But anyway, I'm not going to stay on, but I just want you to know I love this entire family. These are my children, and I would do anything in the world for any one of them. That's it.
Wow, we've been talking about gumbo. I'm getting hungry. Ooh-wee. One of my favorite foods is gumbo. And when you said the big pot, you brought back memories of my mother with the big, like a 5-gallon bucket. Oh, yes. Who know how to make gumbo in here? I want to come to your house. Now, if you don't know how to make it, if it ain't the right color, it ain't the right gumbo. All right. That's a amen. That's what we're talking about.
homegoing. Let's just give the Lord a hand praise for Brother Broussard. As you can look around the place right here, and you can see the love that he left on everybody. Amen? Amen. I love that eulogy. Hey, that's right. That's right. Come on, Brother Williams.
Thank you, Pastor.
Yes, sir.
First of all, giving honor to Almighty God, the supreme engineer, architect, and water master of the universe. To my brothers and sisters in Christ, and especially my brothers and sisters of Central Baptist Church. I know I haven't been here in a while. I'm a friend of Jimmy's. I didn't know Jimmy as a member of this church, so some folks said he didn't fellowship much, and I haven't been fellowshipping myself. This moment is difficult for me, as I believe it is for most of us here. However, we know it's easy to feel sorry at a homegoing celebration. But I tell you who I feel sorry for is all the many people who didn't have the opportunity to meet Jimmy, to work with Jimmy, and just this guy, as most of you know, had a great deal of compassion for people. I got to meet Jimmy as I worked with the Abe Thomas community organization, and he helped me a lot after that, because I'm an elected official on the water board. Jimmy, I didn't have to ask him to join my committee. He volunteered and helped me get reelected or get elected to the West Basin Municipal Water District, whom this is the organization I am representing right now. This was back in 2011. I know all of you know Jimmy, I can tell from the comments that were made about his traits. His traits that show his public service and his caring for people. So I won't go through all of that. What I want to do is let you know what West Basin is going to do for Jimmy. West Basin is a water board here that represents over a million people, and that's who I am representing today. So what I want to do is give to the family this certificate in love, memory of Jimmy, and it reads, West Basin Municipal Water District, in tribute, extends its deepest sympathy on the passing of Jimmy Leroy Broussard, in whose memory the board, in tribute and reverence, at its meeting of October 23rd. The board meeting is this coming Monday, and this board is going to adjourn in memory of Jimmy. And this is the certificate that I'm going to pass on to the family. So with that, thank you for your time, and let's all remember Jimmy. I know you will. You cannot forget the guy. He was a wonderful individual. Thank you.
Amen.
Now we're going to have four friends stand. Due to time restrictions, we want to have four friends. One, two. We got two. Any others? Three, four. Okay, these gentlemen here stand. I don't see any women, but that's cool. Come on down. Make your way over here. And we're going to have the first one is the first one served. So as you line up, come on up to the mic. And remember, it says right here, 2 minutes, please. Please. If you hear me say amen, that means it's time to stop. If you hear me say amen again, that means you've exceeded much past your time. If you hear me say A, and I pause and say man, that means stop or I'm going to walk over. Just don't do nothing to me. Come on up.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
My name is Clarence Dunning, and I lived across the street from Jimmy for the last 35 years plus. I knew all of the family, Dwayne, Ryan, Mark, their spouses, grandchildren. Jimmy helped me from the time I moved on Helmick Street until I can't remember when he wasn't around to be my friend. He would come over and sit in my garage. We drink coffee, talk about people, talk about anybody and everybody. So he was the most caring person that you would ever want to meet. But then he would talk about you too. Don't forget that. So. But I loved him. I love his family. And just be. I'm so heartfelt, I can't really hardly finish, but that was my friend. Thank you.
Hello to the minister, the family, Jimmy Broussard, and everybody. My name is Kevin Thomas. I am the son of Abraham Thomas, who was, my father was the name of the organization that Jimmy was a part of. And I just want to say Jimmy became a counselor to me and my brother after my father passed away and then my mom passed away. He was a very great guy. I spoke to him maybe 4 or 5 weeks before he passed, and the conversation was like normal. He was just checking on me and asking me some stuff like that, and I was asking, you okay? And he said, I'm gonna come check you out, I'm gonna come see you. And I never knew that anything was, any sickness or anything was with him or anything, but Jimmy was great because after my father passed away, Jimmy would come over to my mom's house and water the front and the backyard every day. And I thought that was just something just great because I couldn't be there all the time. That was my father, my brother couldn't be there. And for someone to do that and just have so much respect for my dad and my parents and somebody to come and just take time out of their day and just come and water my parents. And my father was crazy about his grass, and I guess he said, well, he gonna make sure Abe knows that it's getting taken care of down here. So I know that they're up there having some coffee, talking, chopping it up. My dad, he was a great man. I just want to thank you for sharing your dad with me and my family. Thank you very much.
As my wife would say, praise the Lord, saints. Giving all presence and honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who's the head of my life, the pastor of this church, ministers, and my adopted son, Dr. Haley. I met Jimmy, well, first of all, I'm a cement truck driver, so you know I must have met him. I met Jimmy, it must have been in the 90s. We pulled up on a job out here in Lakeview Terrace. Biggest slab I ever seen in my life. I pulled up on the job and I never met him. He said, okay, pull that truck on down to the end and put all them chutes on. I got hanging three chutes. I said, you guys know what a pump look like? We don't use pumps out here. We are professionals. I said, all right. So we get on down there, and I didn't see him for a while, but one of his neighbors, Victor Thompson, not knowing that Jimmy lived across the street from Victor. And I said, Vic, have you seen Jimmy? He said, well, he lived right across the street. So I knocked on the door, and he was telling me, he said, man, I had trouble upstairs. A pipe broke up there, and water came all down here. I said, well, Jimmy, it's okay. I tell you what, you can't finish it with no cement, I said. He said, no, I can't. But Jimmy was an excellent person. And I didn't know him that long, but he was a good man, a good man. And to the family, I want to thank you for sharing him that little time that I had with him. And may the Lord bless and keep you. But as I leave, there was a saying that God is too wise to make a mistake. When your ways seem dark and dreary, and you feel that you can't go wrong, just be encouraging, knowing everything is going to be all right. When your loved one leaves you, there's a void placed in your heart. But just be encouraged that Jimmy had a life in Jesus Christ. May the Lord have blessed and keep you.
Good morning. My name is Huey Taylor, and about the last 10 years, I guess now, I've had the honor and privilege of being the president of the Abe Thomas United Community Organization, of course, of which Jimmy was one of our charter members. There are a number of our members in the back. Would you please stand? Those also associated. Thank you so much, gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. To the family, to the ministers on the dais, in behalf of the Abe Thomas United Community Organization, we want to give you our profound condolences and heartfelt, absolutely heartfelt, for the loss of Jimmy. He was, of course, one of our favorites, and just a very, very kind and free-hearted man. I personally met him in 1985. And I'd moved on Helmick also, but I was on the other end, Cedric. One of the first people I can remember is Jimmy. And he did some outstanding work at my house, and I could drive around. I just can't tell you what a good cement and brick man Jimmy was. I mean, I could drive around Carson and almost point to the house that I know Jimmy did to work because it looked so good. And even in our group, you know, we have historically do fundraisers. We had a New Year's Eve dance and a summer event. Jimmy was the one that always sold the most tickets. I'm not talking about those 5 or 10 tickets. Jimmy would sell 50 or 60 tickets, and you know, so he was just a really, really a fantastic guy. And I know he's in heaven now. I just want him to find us a new coffee shop. So when we get to heaven, we can all be there together. But and my last little story, I talk about how free-hearted he was. My daughter, I used to take her to school, and we'd go to the coffee shop. And there was a couple of times she's pulling money, and she's 7 or 8 years old, pulling money out of her pocket. Where'd you get all that money from? Uncle Jimmy. I said, oh, my God. And I'm not talking about no $5 either. I mean, give me that. We get this back to Jimmy. So every Jimmy come over, she would, oh my God, she really, really would light up. I bet you did. But anyway, he was to the family, very, be so proud of him. He was really a very kind and caring individual and a legend in Carson. I absolutely want to say he was a legend. And let's give him let's give his memory a hand, please. And we, this organization will continue, absolutely continue, in behalf of Jimmy and his memory. God bless everybody. Thank you very much.
In obedience to the Most High, true and living God, to Pastor Wattis and clergy that is here, to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ, certainly last but not least to this bereaved family, we greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus, who is the Christ. Amen. The gentleman before me said he couldn't tell you how good of a cement finisher Jimmy was. I can, and there's some others here that can, because we worked with Jimmy. And yes, Jimmy was a professional. I stood on behalf of those that worked with Jimmy for many, many years. I remember the first day that Jimmy stepped on the job. Cement finisher was not his first job. Jimmy left Local 500 to come to the cement finishers local. And I'll never forget, he came after an accident on his previous job. And Jimmy was a great guy, was a stand-up guy. I have many stories, time will not permit me to tell all. But when you guys talk about the gumbo and how Jimmy loved to eat gumbo, Jimmy loved to eat, period. We used to work in Glendale. There was a restaurant by the name of Foxy's, and we'd go and eat breakfast. It was nothing for Jimmy to eat, half a dozen eggs, pound of bacon. Now, Jimmy would do this in the mornings, but when he hit the job, he would get a pack of Red Man chewing tobacco, and he would massage it so that it would fit in his mouth, and he would keep that all day long. He may not eat again that day on the job, but that was Jimmy Broussard. I want to ask some of the brethren that work with him that I see here to stand, some of the finishers that work with Jimmy, if you would stand up, amen. These are the younger guys. These are the younger guys, and we were Jimmy's family away from home. We worked together, we laughed together, we cried together, and we are here to support this family. To Dwayne, Ryan, and Mark, you guys don't know me, but I've heard a lot about you. Jimmy had three sons, I have three sons, so we would talk about our sons. And certainly, we want you to know that even after today, if you need somebody to talk to, I live in the city. And I've known Jimmy for longer than 38 years. I know that your mother was a church-going woman and she loved the Lord, and I'm sure she planted some of that in you. So when you can't talk to anybody, talk to God. Amen. For the psalmist says, Psalm 46, he's a very present help in your time of trouble. Just know that Jimmy didn't die, but Jimmy has graduated. And if we do what we're supposed to do, some glad morning, we'll see them on the other side. God bless you and God keep you is our prayer. Thank you, pastors, for this time.
Amen, amen. We're going to hear from the ministers. But before we hear from them, I just want to say I had my time of knowing Brother Broussard. I went into Norm's one day, and I saw Brother Felix here and Jimmy sitting at the counter. And as I walked by, Brother Broussard had Brother Felix's ear and wouldn't let go. So he was talking, and I just tapped him on, hey, what's going on, fellas? And as I tapped, Brother Broussard looked around, but he was still going. But I want to say not only that, they had their time in the mall. I'd come through there sometimes, and I thought that was the retirement group over there in that mall, that little circle of men. But anyway, I says, I'm not ready for this. I better keep going. But anyway, always was in good spirits, always. Seemed like he had a permanent smile. That smile on his face seemed permanent. But anyway, we're going to continue. We're going to hear from Dr. Haley. He's going to give us 2 minutes, please. And then we're going to hear from Minister Grover. Amen. So as they come, let's just give the Lord one more hand praise.
Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord. Amen. We thank God that Jesus became sin for us who knew no sin, and he's without spot or blemish. So if you believe that, you don't have to worry about nothing else, because we get into heaven because of the grace of God of what Jesus did. Amen? I just want to say to the family, I knew all the boys since they was, say, knee-high to the grasshopper. You guys are representing well. And your father represented well, whether you realize it or not. Number one, he was not a lazy man. He said, a lazy man that don't take care of his family is worse than an infidel. Your father was a very hard worker. Number two, I call him kind of like the undercover agent. He did a lot of stuff when we were in the process of building this church. When we needed stuff in the landfill, your father, when nobody else was around, would bring stuff to put in the landfill. And a matter of fact, that was the first place I met him. And he was not scared of nobody. And then he said, call the police. He didn't care. He said, put your hands on me, and it's going to be one. You know? The Jimmy, but he was a good guy. He's very respectful. And the book of James says, you know, show me your faith by your works. And that's what he did. He worked. You don't get into heaven by working. But if you have faith, it will work. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Remember, it's a home going, right?
Yes.
Amen, amen. I didn't have the opportunity to know Jimmy, but I knew Minnie. And if I knew Minnie, I knew Jimmy. Because Minnie was anchored in the Lord, and I know that she taught her family those same principles. But what I want to share with the family, let your dad's memories and his legacy live on through you guys. I feel as though I know Jimmy because of what I've heard today. Amen? So to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. In the love of God, let the love of God resonate in your heart, like your aunt said. Let the love of God resonate in your heart. God is love. And if you are his, you have to be love. So don't let hate be a part of you. Let God resonate in your heart. Amen? So there's no sorrow that God cannot comfort. When you're weak, he's strong. That's when he's at his best. When you're weak, God is strong. He's a present help in time of need. So allow your father's legacy to be with you. When you seem as though you can't go on, allow those fond memories to rest and give you comfort and encouragement. But most importantly, let God be the head of your life. Your father was your father on earth, but God is a father that would never leave you. I always tell my kids, I'll leave you with this. I always tell my children that mom and dad will forsake you. Not intentionally, but we will forsake you. But God will never forsake you. He's there with you when you're in need. And so may God comfort you during this time. That's my prayer for you. Amen.
All right, we're going to have the obituary brought to us by Shauna Harris. Immediately after that, we'll have a video tribute, and then we'll have a song, Goodness of God, by Sister Gwendolyn Brown, and then we'll have the eulogy. Amen? And then we'll be ready to move into the recessional. So we're going to come in that order. Amen? Let's give the Lord another hand praise. This is this, yes.
Good morning, family. Good morning, friends. I give an honor to God, who is the head of my life. I just want to thank everybody for all of your support for the family and all of your flowers and calling us and making sure that everybody is okay. We appreciate that. Thank you guys for being here today to support. Jimmy Leroy Broussard was born October 29th, 1942, in Orange, Texas. He was the seventh child of 13 children born to Shelton and Ophelia Broussard. Jimmy was raised in a Christian home where he accepted Christ at an early age from Starlight Baptist Church. Jimmy attended Emma H. Wallace High School in Orange, Texas, where he went on to join the football team and play as a student, a standout football player. In 1962, Jimmy received his high school diploma from Emma H. Wallace High School. After high school, Jimmy was drafted into the United States Army in 1963. He would serve for 5 years and receive an honorable discharge in 1968. Jimmy met the love of his life, Minnie Pearl Davis, on May 1st, 1965. Jimmy was united in marriage to Minnie Pearl Davis, and to this union, three sons were born, Dwayne, Ryan, and Mark. Jimmy was a great provider for his family and decided to relocate his family to Los Angeles, California in 1969 for better opportunities. Shortly after moving to Los Angeles, Jimmy started his career as a cement finisher. He would work as a cement finisher for 38 years until he retired in 2008. Jimmy, being raised in a Christian home, found his church home at Central Baptist Church in 1976. After retirement, Jimmy was very active in the Abram Thomas United Community Organization. Jimmy was preceded in death by his wife, Minnie Broussard, parents Shelton and Ophelia Broussard, brothers Shelton Broussard Jr. and James Broussard, sisters Katie Timms, Lily Hayes Warren, Shirley Bradley, Artis T. Robert, and Deborah Menard Melvin. Jimmy leaves to cherish his memories, three sons, Dwayne, Jennifer, Ryan, and Mark Jamaica, grandchildren Dylan Broussard and Leighton Broussard, brothers Freddie Broussard, Ola, and Henry Broussard, Niecy, sisters Betty Curtis and Claudette Anderson, Nolan Sr., and a host of nieces, nephews, cousins, and friends. Thank you.
Really gonna miss you. It's really gonna be different without you. Time is gonna be hard and slow for the rest of my life. Gonna be thinking about you. Yes, I am. Time came when you had to go. I'll miss you, my buddy. I'll miss you, my friend. I promise my love for you. In your finest hour, I was there with you. And without you, things won't be the same. But
There's a higher power that we answer to, and you heard him calling your name. Really gonna miss you, everything about you, your smiling face. Yes, I know you want us all to be strong. Really gonna miss you. I know you've gone to that magic place. Oh, singing you a brand new song.
Searching for that silver lining, horizons that I've never seen. Oh, I'd like to take just a moment and dream my dream. Oh, dream my
to drink. And I really want to thank y'all. This has been beautiful.
We're going to do this more often. I'm going to have another book that's so we can do it again. it's just been something really special. So you don't have to worry about it. You can take that to the bank and get a stamp rebate. Man, I tell you, man, being with my family makes my life. I really, really enjoyed it. It ain't over yet till it's over. We might not get out here tomorrow. We might see another day. Shit, Brian gonna break away from me. Oh, man. It's special. This was special. I really enjoyed it. And I'm not prepared to make this video, but if I was, oh man, I'd lay you out. I'd lay you out. But something to stand with all this beautiful scenery for what my family has done for me, it's just been lovely. I don't know what to say. Shit. I don't know whether to take a drink or start drinking or stop drinking. It's been nice. Mm-hmm. Fill my heart up.
Your mercies never fail me at all. You held me in your hand from the moment that I wake up till I lay my head. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Thank you.
you.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Can we just give the Lord another hand clap for the testimony and the prayers that have went before us today? Man, it is indeed a pleasure to be here today. My name is Minister Willie Brightman, and I will be doing the eulogy. And I don't feel like it's much that I have to do. There's been so much been said about our brother and the life that he lived and the things that he done and the way he impacted each and every person's life that spoke on what was said. And I said, man, praise the Lord. You know, what a testimony. And I was thinking today when I was asked to do the eulogy, and I would say, well, I thought about going to 1 Corinthians and talking about the body change that we take during the transition from this life to the next life. Then I thought about, hey, how do we live in that when Jesus said he's coming back, we'd be ready to be raptured up? And then I just said, well, you know what, Lord, give me something to do. And then I thought about all the cards that I received on Christmas time, and I got a couple of cards during the time of bereavement. And so I said, well, Lord, what can I say that would minister and impact people, that would lift up and glorify our brother Jimmy Broussard? And the God gave me this. Tell him about witnessing. Witnessing. And as I go through this message today, you understand what I mean. We talk about witnessing. Most of the time when we think about witnessing, we think about people coming with you with the scripture. They are talking about Jesus Christ, or how they live, the things he's done, and the promises of God. But there's a way to witness, and I'll call it the type witnesses that I'm going to be talking about today in scripture. Part of what be like more like evangelizing. And before we get into the scripture today, I'd just like to do a quick prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we just come before your presence once again in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus. Lord, we do thank you for this time that you've given me to bring forth the eulogy today. Lord, I pray that the things that I say will be a comfort to this family that during their time of bereavement. Lord, that it will minister to those that even don't know you in the pardon of their sins. And so, for Lord, I just want to say thank you for that. But most of all, Lord, I pray that this will bring honor and glory to your name. This prayer we ask in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. I was looking at some of the things all this testimony we spoke about Mr. Jimmy Broussard, and I was trying to think of some of the things that as I was looking at that we kind of had in common. And one of the things was that he comes from a family of 12. I'm from a family of 12. And so he was a husband, a father, and a grandfather, uncle, cousin, a friend. And I can relate to all those things. I fit into all those categories. So we had some things in common. But the most thing that I can say about Brother Jimmy that my relationship would be with him would be with his wife, Minnie, and that I was involved in a convalescent home here at Central Baptist. And Minnie was involved in that with me, her and her sister Della Smith. And so we spent many years doing the convalescent home ministry together. And she was a person that was on fire for the Lord. And we speak about Jimmy, how he would like to talk and debate. I guarantee you, when it came to the Word of God, if you come to Minnie, you was gonna get a debate if you was doing it right. So she knew the Word, and she didn't mind sharing it. And she didn't mind debating with you when things came to the Lord. And so that's one of the things I have to always remember, Sister Minnie by Sister Della. And so I do thank you for this time that I have here before you. And when I was thinking about witnessing, I guess we always just start with a scripture. And first of all, I'm going to give a definition of witnessing, and I had written it down. It's a testation of a fact or event. And it means you want to bear witness about, give evidence about something that you believe in. And it's a CSL witness of that solemn official declaration. And I was thinking about the cards and the thing that I received from Brother Jimmy, and they would always have something about Jesus in them. It wasn't, you know, Xmas or anything, you would see the baby in the manger, or you would see Jesus. It would be always something that would remind you of who Jesus was, why he came, and the purpose that he was here on this earth. And so that told me something about Jimmy, is that when he sent those cards out, that was what he believed. And he was faithful on sending cards out. In fact, sometimes he would send them out so early, I think a few Christmases, I got two. I got one like in November and another one in December. I respond to one, and next thing I know, I got another one coming up. So what am I supposed to do here? Send another response, you know? Because I always try to make sure that when I received a card, that I would already respond to it. So I guess he wanted to make sure. So he sent two sometimes. So I sent him two back. So I don't know. So we replied to it. But then if we go to a scripture, when I thought about it, they said, I'm going to use an old scripture here, Proverbs 14:25. And it said, a true witness delivers souls, but a deceitful witness speak lies. And I was thinking about, we know that Jimmy was not a deceitful witness. He was a true witness. And I would go one step further. When the men and women came up here to testify about Jimmy, one of the things that they spoke of was that Jimmy spoke or said what was on his mind. And so when he did that, he had to be truthful and had a belief in what he was saying, didn't he? And he let you know what was on his mind, so he spoke up. So I thought that was great. That says something about his character and things that how he felt about life, being outspoken. And so the cause that he sent during the Christmas was always a witness to me about how he felt about Jesus. He believed in the Lord. So he believed that he may not have been doing some of the things like we normally do, like being in the ministry, speaking, teaching, doing all the things, but he was a witness for the Lord through the card that he sent out. Amen. Another thing, you said, someone else was talking about witnessing, said, I think it was Minister Dr. Haley, witnessing is, we know it involves faith that we have in Jesus Christ, but the faith that we have, some people say, well, do our faith come with works? It is works that save us. No. Our works do not save us. It's our faith that saves us. But I feel like this, if you have faith, you're going to have some works to go along with that faith. There's going to be something that has to be done. So we get back to Jimmy again. He had faith, but he had works. What was he doing? Sending out those cards. What was that doing? Witnessing. He was telling people about Jesus. So we know that. And so we know that as Jimmy sent those cards out, he was doing a witness, he was evangelizing, and they were reaching out all over the world. It made me think about when Jesus told the disciples that he was going to send them a comforter that would empower them to do the work of the ministry. They would spread the gospel, starting in Judea, Samaria, and to the uttermost parts of the world. And how did they do that? They did that through the power of the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit be working in our life, the Holy Spirit working in Jimmy, enabled him to do that, because I do believe it took time for him to sit down, get all those addresses, get all those cards, and send them out to each individual or the families that he sent them to. So what was that doing? Witnessing. Brother Jimmy Broussard was witnessing by sending those cards to all the people that he knew, or the ones that he wanted to reach and to tell them something about Jesus. I'm kind of looking at the time here. I know we have to get out of here in a few minutes, and I'll kind of compile some things. And when we talk about Jimmy, and we say, what did he do? We know that he wasn't a preacher. He wasn't a deacon. He wasn't an usher. He wasn't a choir member. He wasn't a musician, was he? But what was he did some work by sending out his cards. And the things that he doing, what was he doing again? Witnessing. He wasn't involved in the church. I've been in Central here now for almost 26 years, and I have not saw Jimmy in the church. But I'll tell you what, I've been in this church here for that long, and some of them I have never received a Christmas card from. or Arima. So that says something about Jimmy, doesn't it? So praise the Lord for Brother Jimmy. He was a witness, you know. So I thank the Lord for that. The cause, when I think about another thing about the cause, that when they sent it out, it reminds me of why Jesus came to the earth, you know. The cause remind me of what Jesus did while he was here. He taught, he teached, he did all those things. He ministered, he healed, he raised the dead. He did quite a few things. And for us that believe, those things were confirmation in our heart. I know God healed me with some sickness or illness. I know God has blessed you through your finances. I know some of you, God has repaired some of your relationship. But we know that whenever you receive those cards that represented the work of Jesus, it told you or reminded you of something or some way that the Lord had an impact in your life. God has did something. I would believe for everyone that's saved in here today, there has been something that God has done for you. There should be something that you would have a testimony about the goodness of God, how he has worked in your life. And so whenever you receive one of those cards, it would probably remind you of some of those things that God had done in your life just because Jimmy sent you a card at Christmas time. A Christmas card telling you who Jesus was and the work he did, on the cross of Calvary, that he came, that he hung on that cross, that he bled, that he died, that he was buried, that he's raised, and he is now at the right hand of the Father making intercession for you and I. That card represented the work of the cross. And it was given to you by Jimmy. And so that means, what was Jimmy doing again? He was witnessing. Think about that, witnessing. Not only in witnessing that, and also when he was witnessing, he was giving you a testimony of what he believed and how he felt about the Lord. And so I heard someone say, I think it was his brother, was speaking a little bit earlier about, you know, that where he would be in glory with him one day and all these things. I do believe that too, because the Lord put this in my spirit to go this way. Tell the people about witness. We all should be a witness for the Lord. And this is an inspiration to me. You know, sometimes we feel like the minister said in the pulpit, the choir we have to be seen. But no, there is some people working behind the scenes. You're going to be surprised who you see in glory. You're going to be surprised who you see in glory. And I do believe that one of them you're going to see in glory is our brother Jimmy. Jimmy, he's going to be there in glory with us, right? And I thought about this scripture song came up. We think about Brother Jimmy. I think it's John 14, verses 1 through 3. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go away to prepare a place for you. If I go prepare a place for you, I will come again to receive you to myself, that where I am, you may be where? Also, so guess what? When Jimmy made this transition, guess where he's at? He's in the presence of the Father. He is receiving the blessings and the benefits of the things that he had done in his faith and belief. Because the scripture says also what? To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Amen. Ain't that good news? Ain't that good news? I know I'm supposed to try to get out of here by 12 o'clock, so I'm going to come to the end of this, but I had a lot more I was going to be saying, but I'm going to cut it short because I think we know the gist of things and how things work. And I want to say this here, is that, when the time comes and the things that we've done for Christ and the life that we've lived, and we know one day we'll be standing there and that we'll be looking forward to receiving rewards for the work of our labor. And some of us, you know, we would, we're going to have a reward, they're going to have crowns. And some of us, we don't know what the rewards we're going to see. And some of us, the rewards, the scripture don't really give a good detail of them. And we don't know how many, how they work. But some of us may have one. And some of us may have more than one. And you know who decides who's going to get the rewards? It's the Lord Jesus. And how is those decisions is made is how we have did the things that God have called us to do while we was here on this earth. And Jimmy did his thing, amen? And so as I close, as 12 o'clock, as I close, he said, and I thought about this verse, we go to Matthew 25:34. He said, then shall the king say to them on his right hand, come ye blessed of my father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Amen. And that's what my father is going to be saying to Brother Jimmy, because he knew us before we were formed in our mother's womb. He knew us even before the foundation of the world. And Jimmy is now going in the presence of the Lord, in rejoicing and enjoying the work that he did while he's here on earth forevermore. Amen. God bless you. That is our message for today. We'll all see Jimmy where? In heaven. And if you, for those of you that don't know him, get to know him. God bless you. Amen.
Thank you. Amen. Amen. Let's give the Lord another hand praise. Yes. Thank you for that beautiful word from Minister Willie Brightman. So good. It is just so good to know the Lord. And there may be somebody here that never accepted Christ. And the fact is that it is the most important thing you could do is to have Jesus as the Lord of your life. Without him, you'll be eternally separated from God if you pass today. But with him, you'll be with him on the other side when you pass. So get to know Jesus. Amen. Amen. I'm going to turn it over to the directors at this time, and I just want to say a few words to the family, to Dwayne, Ryan, and Mark. Know that your parents left a great legacy. Your dad is now with your mom in glory. Learn from the great things and let their legacy that they've left you live on through the rest of your family, generation after generation. If there's anything that we could do for you here at Central, we stand and wait for you. Anything, just let us know. Amen. Our prayers are with you. Continue to trust God as you've pretty much known through your life. God is the way. Trust him. Lean on him for your strength. Amen. Amen. Our directors, if you could take over at this time. Amen. Thank you.